I'm going to film school.
Well, hopefully. Let me explain. Okay, so around 3 years ago, we had a little thing you may have heard of. It. COVID-19. You familiar? You weren't? Holy shit. Where have you been? It was a rough time for most people. We were all stuck inside and we were mostly all forced to do one thing. Kill time. Do whatever we could. And so what I spent my time doing, watching YouTube. And in those moments where I watched YouTube, I discovered something that has now changed the course of my life. The behind the scenes of TV shows and movies. I know, that's strange. How could that possibly change my life? Well, up to that point, I'd be making YouTube videos for a while on and off, but in that moment in lockdown, I had so much free time, all I did was make so many videos. Point was, I had been making video skits for so long, and I never stopped. Obviously, I was on and off, but like, it was always a thing that kept coming back to me. I've always been one to pick up hobbies and never really continue with them after a while. This was one that always stuck with me. It's just something I always did, and I spent a lot of time looking more into the behind the scenes of how movies and TV shows are made, and I discovered that I was fascinated with it. All the different ways that they captured every shot, all the visual effects, all the practical effects, every single bit of work that goes into making a film or TV show like that. Like, for example, The Mandalorian. I think I actually watched that show after I learned how they made it, because I was more interested in how they made it than the actual show. Obviously, I watched the show and it was amazing, but you see my point here. I discovered that I was absolutely just fascinated by the whole process of making films, filmmaking, or TV shows, movies, YouTube videos. You know, Corridor Crew, for example, I watched their videos forever, on loop. Just, they gave so much insight into everything that goes into a type of production like that, and it just so fascinating. And about halfway through lockdown, I decided that I wanted to make a show, an animated TV show. It was me and Zach, we had two people, and that's it. So we had to, unfortunately, kind of put it on the back burner. I still would love to make it, but that's not the point. Through making that, spending every day scripting it out, plotting out all the scenes for when we could actually go out and film it again, I just loved every second of it. I didn't shut up about it. So many people who would talk to me would be so sick of me talking about it. But that's a good thing, because when we got out of lockdown, I decided to enter a film festival. Yeah, and we won. We won an award for best acting in the film festival, and during the whole process of making it, even though I think in the end it's not my best work, I just never shut up about it. It's all I could think about. And in that moment, while I was like making it, while I just couldn't shut up about it, I realized that finally, I'd found what I was passionate about. Well, I just fell in love with the process. But the truth behind it, I think I was just always in love with it. I'd been making skits, little movies, little stupid things with my brother for so long. And for the whole time, up to this point, I had no idea what I was going to do with my future at all. I didn't know where I was going to go to university. I didn't know what I was going to study. I didn't even know what A-levels I was going to pick. And that was like not even a year from then. But then during that production, it hit me that that's what my passion is. It was then, it still is now, which is why the point of this video, I've applied to film schools. I applied very recently, and now I'm just waiting on offers. They requested my portfolio and I sent that over. If you want to know what that looks like, I am going to be putting that up after this video, or I'm going to point to it at the end, but you can click on it after, see if I'm any good or I'm just terrible, and you know, make your own judgments on it. But you know, I just want to show you guys that. But the point of this video is that if you were like me and you were like, what, I was like 16, I didn't know what I was going to do with my life. I was like 16? No, I was 15. Do not worry, seriously, because I had no idea. I had nothing figured out, and then all of a sudden, it just clicked. I just realized this is what I want to do. This is my future. And once you realize that, all you have to do is just work towards it. If it's really your passion, it's not work. I know my upload schedule is not great, but I cannot go a day without thinking what I'm going to create next. I'm sure there's other people who are creative or are passionate about creative things or want to go into some kind of part of the creative industry, and you probably think the exact same. There's not a second goes by when you're not thinking of what you're gonna make next, what you're gonna do next. You almost feel bored when you're not working on something creative. That's how I feel. Maybe I'm just like a workaholic or something. Maybe I'm just insane, but that's how I feel. And that could be about any passion you have. Say you're like interested in sports. There's not a second that goes by where you're not thinking about what you're gonna train next, how you're gonna win the next game, how you're gonna score more points, whatever. That means that's your passion. That's what you love. And that's what you should try and pursue as far as you can. But if you're really passionate about something and you really have a proper work ethic, you can achieve anything you want. I am not kidding, anything. I'm saying this before I got any offers. If I respond in a couple days saying, bad news, guys, I didn't get in, then disregard anything I'm saying right now and just do what you want to do. But if you see in a couple days or a week me posting videos saying, I'm going to film school or something like that, then I think that you should listen to me and you should subscribe, because very small percentage of you are actually subscribed, so you should subscribe. And if you want to follow my whole journey towards going to film school, like, I'm going to document the whole process of being there. I'm gonna make a lot more film student orientated content, stuff like that. If you want to follow that whole journey, because it's getting closer and closer, click subscribe. I wanted to make this video going out to the people who don't know what they're gonna do. That sounds bad, but you get what I mean. The people who don't know where their future is, what their future holds, just to tell you, you'll figure it out. Even if you're 15, if you're 30, even if you're 65 years old and you think that you haven't found your passion, you still have time. Time is your biggest friend. A lot of people say it's your biggest enemy, but things could like just click at any time. It could happen when you're 3 years old, or it can happen when you're 65. It doesn't matter. The point is that if you don't know right now, you will. There's no doubt about it. If you really put your mind to thinking about what your passion could be, what you really love, then you're gonna find out, and then that's gonna lead you in some great directions. Well, anyway, that's my little update. I could be going to film school. You'll see in like a week if I have gotten in or whatever. I'm going to update you guys along the whole way. You guys are in this with me. So if you want to stick around and see that, please hit that subscribe button. Check out my portfolio up here. Please be kind. And I'll see you all next time. Bye.